Thank you very much for your kind words. So I am very much honored here and pleased because, you know, this conference is something which I like very much and have been, let's say, involved in for so many years. And I would like to thank Professor Abaidat for his invitation because this is a great honor to me. So I would like to say something which is maybe, you know, strange, but as you will see, there is something which is in line with modern trends in science and technology. Okay, so as you see, there is human in the loop, very strange, you know, the description. And human-centric computing paradigms. So in fact, I will be speaking more about human-centric computing paradigms and making reference to human in the loop because it's more general. So basically, what is... A moment, please. Okay, so maybe if I can put it here, it will be better. Okay. Yes?
I think you have that.
Oh, yes. Yes, oh, thank you very much. Mm-hmm. If you can do this, it will be easier for me. Sorry. Sorry. Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Yes. Okay. Yes. Okay. Okay.
Yes.
Okay. So basically, you know, if you, in the case of a plenary talk, so there is some sort of a challenge for the speaker. Because it should be concerned with some challenge or something that is important for the field, let's say, in general. So I think that in my talk concerns the so-called big challenges facing IT and ICT. So if you look, for instance, at the National Science Foundation, so they say something like this, you know. There are the following monumental research challenges, each requiring at least a decade of concentrated research to make substantive progress. Computers to be cognitive partners for humans. This is very important. Personalized lifelong learning is extremely important, but I will not speak about this. Unfailingly reliable system is extremely important, but we will not speak about this. And making information technology less complex to the human. This is extremely important also, because everybody is using cognitive technology and they are not computer specialists. Okay, now what happens? So what is the situation now? So first of all, everybody knows that we have a growing complexity of everything. So for instance, social, technological, economic processes and systems, and we must make good decisions. I'm not speaking about optimal, good. Good is okay. And we must find way to, let's say, by using whatever is good and useful for us. Simulation also, but we have to solve problems, you know. And we have to arrive at those good decisions. Good, maybe, useful, whatever, but not always optimal. And there is a growing discrepancy, like a so-called gap, between the old practical concept.